HIV/AIDS is the most notorious of all the known sexually transmitted diseases around the world. Unfortunately, the statistics of infected persons keeps increasing year in, year out. According to UNAIDS Global HIV statistics, an estimated 39 million people around the world were living with HIV as at the end of year 2022, about 1.3 million people became newly infected with the virus, while about 630,000 people died from AIDS-related illnesses by the end of the same year. It's worth noting that HIV and AIDS are two different phenomena. While HIV stands for Human Immunodeficiency Virus, AIDS is an acronym for Acquired Immune Deficiency Syndrome. HIV is the virus that causes AIDS by destroying the immune system of infected persons. People get infected with this virus when it enters their body through any of the body fluids, most especially blood and sex fluids. Body fluids such as tear drops and saliva contain only a little amount of the virus. HIV is of two different types, which are commonly referred to as HIV-1 and HIV-2. HIV-1 is a very aggressive virus and it progresses very fast, while HIV-2 is less infectious. It progresses slowly and can be adequately managed with the use of antiretroviral drugs, AVR. HIV-1 is more complex than HIV-2 because it has groups and subtypes. The known HIV-1 groups are M, N, O, and P, with group M being the major group. The group M is also the most prevalent strain around the world and has subtypes A, B, C, D, F, G, H, J, and K. Hybrid strains can be developed when these subtypes are genetically combined. A person infected with HIV does not show any immediate symptoms and may even test negative months after getting infected, and this is because the disease has a window period. HIV-1 has about 1 month window period, while HIV-2 has a period of 3 months and above before the infected person can test positive. Moreover, the infected persons may look and feel healthy until the virus finally begins to destroy their body immune system and thereby making them vulnerable to all kinds of sicknesses, which are referred to as opportunistic infections, and it is at this point that AIDS sets in. AIDS is the final stage of HIV infection, where the immune system of the infected person is gradually depleted or weakened to the point that it can no longer resist or fight even the weakest germ. At this stage, the infected person is at the mercy of opportunistic infections such as pneumonia, tuberculosis, diarrhea, skin cancer, and so on. More often than not, the barrage of opportunistic infections overwhelms the body and leads to the death of the infected person because their body cannot fight the infections. It should be noted that infected persons can get infected over and over again as long as they keep getting in contact with the virus. The most common way of contracting HIV is through sexual contact with an infected person. Other means by which a person can get infected with HIV include: 1. Taking unscreened blood that has HIV virus through blood transfusion. 2. Sharing sharp, piercing or pointed objects with an infected person. 3. Mother-to-child transmission during pregnancy, childbirth, or breastfeeding. Although symptoms may vary from person to person, the common symptoms of HIV at the early stage include fever, chills, rash, night sweat, diarrhea, gradual weight loss, sore throat, muscle aches, fatigue, mouth thrush or ulcer, and swollen lymph nodes. Symptoms at the later AIDS stage include: 1. Bad and chronic cough. 2. Recurring fever and profuse night sweat. 3. Extreme and inexplicable fatigue. 4. Prolonged swelling of the lymph glands in the neck, armpits, or groins. 5. Severe diarrhea, rapid weight loss, and tumors. 6. Treatment-resistant sores at the mouth, anus, or the genital area. 7. Red, brown, pink, or purplish blotches under the skin or inside the mouth, nose, or eyelids. 8. Depression, neurological disorder, and memory loss. HIV is a preventable disease. Some of the ways in which you can protect yourself from getting infected with HIV include: 1. The use of pre-exposure prophylaxis. Medical scientists in the United Kingdom have started the production of an HIV preventive drug known as pre-exposure prophylaxis. The drug is engineered to protect HIV-negative individuals from being infected with HIV even if they come in contact with the virus. Undoubtedly, this drug will go a long way in reducing the spread of HIV. 2. Avoid having unprotected sex by using condoms correctly and consistently. 3. Abstinence from sex or delaying sex till marriage. 4. Staying faithful to one partner who has tested negative for HIV and other STDs. 5. Always make sure that blood is properly screened before transfusion is done. 6. Avoid using unsterilized needles and syringes. 7. Avoid sharing sharp, piercing, and pointed objects such as scissors, razor blade, and clippers with other people. 8. Proper monitoring during pregnancy. Infected pregnant women should have proper monitoring right from the prenatal to the postnatal period so that necessary precautions will be taken to ensure that the baby does not get infected. Moreover, HIV-positive nursing mothers should avoid breastfeeding their babies so as to avoid transmitting the virus to them through the breast milk. The management and treatment of HIV include the following. Number 1. Administering antiretroviral drugs. These drugs help prevent the replication of HIV, thereby inhibiting the virus from damaging the body and also prevent the infection from progressing into the AIDS stage through the reduction of the viral load in the body. According to UN AIDS statistics, an estimated 29.8 million people living with HIV had access to antiretroviral therapy as at December 2022. Antiretroviral drugs has 6 different classes. The first class antiretroviral drugs are known as the nucleoside analog reverse transcriptase inhibitors. This class of drugs prevents the completion of a viral DNA chain during the infection of a new cell by the human immunodeficiency virus. The second class ARV drugs are non-nucleoside analog reverse transcriptase inhibitors. This class blocks the action of HIV by binding and inducing the production of a hydrophobic pocket towards the active site. In the third class are the protease inhibitors. This class of antiretroviral drugs interrupts viral repetition at a later stage in the HIV's life cycle. The fourth class ARV drugs are called the integrase strand transfer inhibitors. This class blocks the action of a viral enzyme called integrase, which inserts the viral genome into the DNA of an infected person. The fifth class drugs are known as the fusion inhibitors. These ARV drugs inhibits the virus from entering and infecting the CD4 cell, thereby preventing it from replicating within the cell. In the sixth and last class, we have the coreceptor antagonists. These drugs inhibit the actions of CCR5 receptor and consequently prevent HIV from entering the cells of an infected individual. Number 2. Having a stem cell transplant. Although this treatment is a work in progress, doctors believe that it is a potential permanent cure for HIV. The first successful case of stem cell transplant as a cure for HIV was carried out in 2006 in Berlin, Germany. A second successful case of such a transplant was announced in 2019 in England. However, it should be noted that the stem cells needed for this type of HIV cure are special ones. Such stem cells must carry 2 copies of the Delta 32 mutation in the CCR5 gene, thereby preventing blood cells from possessing a CCR5 receptor, which is the receptor through which the HIV/AIDS virus enters the body cells. Hence, it goes without saying that anyone who has 2 copies of the Delta 32 mutation cannot contract HIV, however, only a few people possess this mutation. Number 3. Treating opportunistic infections such as candida, diarrhea, cough, warts, and fever. Number 4. Indulging in nutritious food. Eating healthy, balanced diet helps prevent weight loss and strengthens the body against the effects of opportunistic infections. Number 5. Living a healthy lifestyle. It's imperative for HIV-infected persons to embrace a healthy lifestyle, which includes eating a balanced diet and staying active. More importantly, HIV-positive people should refrain from smoking, alcohol consumption, and having unprotected sex so as to prevent getting reinfected. On a final note, it is important to emphasize the fact that the earlier the treatment of HIV, the better the chances of winning the battle. In addition, the early detection of HIV goes a long way in curtailing its spread and curbing its damaging effects. Therefore, your urge to get tested for HIV as soon as possible. Thanks for watching.